First of all, on behalf of Radio Soul, we'd like to welcome you and let you know that we got mad listeners out here, and they're very excited about the tour. And we've actually sent out some information about you on our live broadcast, and we asked the callers to call in and give us a list of questions that they would like to know about Dwelly. So, but before I even get into that, I want to just ask you to bring us up to speed on what it is that we don't know about you. We know that you released The Rise. It was a self-released LP in 2000. Yeah. In 2003, Subject. In 2005, it was Some Kinda. In 2008, it was Sketches of a Man. What's been going on with you since then?
A lot, man. A lot. You know, since then, I've been working. Actually, I'm currently working on the next album. Uh-huh. We're looking to drop it in June. Also, I've been actually working a lot with cameras, you know, like shooting videos and getting into videography.
Okay.
You know, I think that's like another aspect of creativity that goes hand in hand with music. You know,
same
music and videos. So, you know, that's something that I've really been dabbling with, you know, having fun with.
All right. Well, that's what's up. I mean, we be checking you on your YouTube, and we got to meet Rockstar a little bit. So we with you right there. Want to big you up on the Michael tribute that you did. Rest in peace.
Well,
that was fly. Some of the questions we got is, like, the first one is, what is the main driving force that motivates you to create music?
I think for me, you know, music is just a release, man. Even more so than music, I think art in itself is just a release, you know, whether it's painting, sketching, you know, photography, videography, music, you know what I'm saying? It's a release, man. So, you know, whenever I need to get something off my chest, whenever I'm not feeling as vocal as I should be, you know, I kind of get it out through my art, you know, and most times it's through music.
Well, that must be a relief, I can imagine. Another question they got here is, what has been the biggest highlight in your career thus far?
Man, I had a lot of highlights, you know. That's a hard question to answer, man.
Isn't it though?
Yeah, the beauty of being in music, man, is, you know, you never really know what's gonna happen next for you. You never know where you'll be tomorrow. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
This can take you. One day you're sitting in Detroit, the next you're in Munich, Germany.
You see?
You know what I'm saying? You never know. You know what I'm saying? But I think, man, just like all around, man, just the fact that I got a chance to travel, you know, I got a chance to really see things that a lot of people from where I come from don't get a chance to see. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And to me, that's been a beautiful thing, man. Other than that, like a singular event that's been great for me would have to be performing on stage at the Montreux Jazz Festival with Roy Ayers. That right there was like a dream come true, you know, because I grew up listening to Roy, man. So to have that happen, you know, was crazy for me.
I can imagine. Let me keep going with the questions because we got a grip of them, actually.
Okay.
You did some features with Boney James, Slum Villa, Kanye, Drake, Bahamadia, Common, the whole nine. Which artist could you imagine collaborating with that you haven't already collaborated with?
There's a ton of artists that I love to work with that I haven't already. I wouldn't even know how to answer that, man. I always say that I want to get on the joint with with Ghostface.
Ghost.
You know what I'm saying? I love to work with Ghostface, except I be rhyming and he's singing.
All right.
You know what I'm saying? Let's throw a monkey wrench in the whole plan.
Well, let me ask you this. What is it about Ghost, in particularly, that you feel like y'all would vibe real well?
I love the way Ghost tells stories. You know what I'm saying? Like with his lyrics, he paints a picture for you. If you close your eyes and really listen to his lyrics, you can see everything. He's so vivid with the words that he uses and the things that he decides to put into the rhyme to tell his story.
Yeah.
You know, he does it different than everybody else. You know what I'm saying? I like to think that when you listen to my songs, I like to think that I paint a picture, you know, with my music too, you know, so I love to get with him and work like that.